Alzheimer's disease is the most common form of dementia. According to various statistics, it accounts for about 60 to 80% of all patients presenting with neurodegenerative disease. And its root cause is the accumulation of both beta amyloid plaques and tau neurofibrillary tangles in the brain parenchyma. My name is Anna Franceschi. I'm a neuroradiologist at Lenoxville Hospital, which is a division of Northwell Health in New York City. I run the brain PET imaging service for the Northwell Health System, where we scan about 1,500 brain PETs a year. Approximately 70% of those are in patients with Alzheimer's disease, and that's the primary focus of my clinical work. MRI is a key component of the diagnostic pathway for patients with Alzheimer's disease and other dementias. And what we use MRI and structural imaging overall is really to try and exclude or identify potentially reversible causes of cognitive decline, such as, for example, normal pressure hydrocephalus, and also to detect coexisting pathologies, such as, for example, the degree of vascular burden that's present in these patients as well, which can then accelerate the progression of cognitive impairment. So PET imaging is indispensable in the diagnosis of Alzheimer's disease and other dementias, as it provides us a functional imaging tool to assess, first of all, with FDG PET, differential lobar-specific patterns of hypometabolism, which allows us to provide a differential diagnosis and identify not only Alzheimer's disease, but other dementias as well. And then we can get into more specific molecular imaging. For example, we have amyloid PET to detect the accumulation of beta amyloid plaque in the cortex. We also have tau PET to detect the accumulation of the abnormal neurofibrillary tangles. And then we also have, more recently, F-dopa PET, which allows us to image striatonigral degeneration. So we're very lucky currently to have hybrid imaging and specifically PET MRI as a tool that can be used in the clinical setting. And really what we have by combining both structural and functional imaging modalities at the same time is that, you know, we add the structural imaging component of MRI, which allows us to overcome inherent difficulties to anatomic localization on PET. And it also allows us to identify or exclude coexisting pathologies and various comorbidities. And then, of course, in contrast to prior PET CT scanners, we don't have the radiation dose that is inherent to the CT component. And finally, patients make just one visit to the imaging clinic rather than two separate visits for both an MRI and a PET. In terms of disease-modifying therapies for Alzheimer's disease, actually last summer, July 2023, the FDA gave traditional approval to Leqembi, or lecanemab, which is a monoclonal antibody targeting the beta amyloid plaques that accumulate in patients with Alzheimer's disease. It was actually the first new treatment since memantin in 2003, so in almost 20 years, and it was also the first disease-modifying drug, meaning a drug that's not just intended to treat the patient's symptoms, but actually stop or even reverse the progression of the underlying pathophysiology.